What up, y'all? It's Jermaine Dupri. I'm the motherfucking mayor of the ATL, and you're watching Scott Emo Show. The Scott Emo Show.
Bitch, I'm just gonna say bitch. I was waiting for you to do that. I didn't know you were gonna do that.
A Ferrari, a Jaguar, switching four lanes, top down, screaming out, money ain't a thing.
Bubble hard in the double law, flashing the rings with the window cracked, holla back, money ain't a thing.
Jigga, I don't like it if it don't gleam, gleam in the hell with the price, but the money ain't a thing.
Put it down hard for my dogs that's locked in the bang. When you hit the bricks, new whips, money ain't a thing.
Come on. Yeah, I wanna floss with us. Come on, all across the board, we burn it up. Drop a little paper, baby, toss it up. Slacking on your pimping, turn it up. See, the money ain't a thing.
Flex the bro, sign a check for your hoe. Jigga style is love, X and O. Save all your accolades, just the dough. My game is wide, all names aside. Trying to stay alive, 100,000 for the bracelet. Foolish ain't out of chain of straight.
In the Ferrari and Jaguar, switching four lanes with the top down, screaming out,
money ain't a thing.
We have Jermaine Dupri on the Scott Emo Show, hip hop mogul, legendary producer, founded so many great people. You've been in the business for 20 plus years.
Yeah.
What's the secret to your longevity?
You gotta love what you're doing, and then you gotta put that first. I always put my music and my career as like the first thing that I think about, and it just continues to keep you, you know, you want to keep making it happy.
Right.
It's almost like a relationship, like a marriage. You know what I mean? You want to continue to keep making it happy, and in return, it makes you happy. So it's like,
how much more do you have to? So in a relationship, right? You, from the guy's perspective, you have to put in some hard work.
Yeah.
So in order to make the music happy, how? I mean, you must put in a lot of hours. What's the dedication like in order to be on the level that you're at?
I mean, it's a heavy dedication. I mean, it's like, you know, it's even like this DJing thing. Like, people don't really understand, like, how, you know, if you DJ, you know, one big club, and why you want to do a smaller club.
Right.
And why, you know, it's like the dedication is not about the size of the room. The dedication is about the act of, right? So that's basically it. It's like you just, you know, you go with the motions and whatever. The surroundings have nothing to do with it. It's the moments that you get to spend with the time and do what you gotta do.
I respect. I mean, that's the point of why we started the show, because it's not the audience size.
Yeah.
It's the content that matters.
Yeah, totally.
And if you're putting out the good content, people will automatically resonate with it.
Yeah, eventually. I mean, you know, everybody will see it and be like, yo,
that's dope.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, now that I have JD on the Scott Emo Show, that's dope.
Yeah. All word right. up.
So you've been around the block for a long time.
Yeah.
Top five dead or alive.
Man. Jay-Z, Biggie, Pop. Not in the order. Eminem.
B.O.B.
Number five. I'm trying to figure out.
We are in Chicago. Is he on your list?
Nah, not on my list.
That's not really. I'd rather have you be honest than not.
Top five dead or alive, but I don't know if it's a fifth person that I even feel like fits in that. In those four guys.
Those guys are just on another planet.
Not even on another planet. I mean, they just understand. It's a thing about making records, and it's a thing about rapping. And if you know both, which most rappers don't, most
right.
rappers know one, and they just rap and rap and rap, and then, but then you got these other guys that make songs with those same type of lyrics a part of it. So it gives you, as a listener, something really to listen to. I mean, it's just, I don't really know if I have a number five on that list. And I think that I leave five open because it's a couple of other guys out there that could plug and play. They could get in that spot, but I don't know if, you know, you got to see. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I don't, you know. I don't think Biggie, to me, is like.
Is he one?
Probably. Because, you got to look at his resume. I mean,
it's so extensive.
He had two albums, and everything from those two albums was heard.
Right.
It ain't a bunch of rappers that can say that. Like, wherever we all listen to every song from both albums.
What's your favorite Biggie lyric?
Um, Real Reality Rap is Biggie. He said, people said I died dead in the street. Nigga, I'm getting high and getting head on a beast. Chilling.
That's not a bad life. I one aspires to live that life. But you said reality rap, and I think that brings us to our next question. Chris Kelly, may his soul rest in peace.
Yeah.
From Chris Cross, who you discovered performed at your 20th year anniversary concert, by the way, which was one of the most phenomenal celebrations that I've seen.
Thank you.
I mean, you brought out everybody.
Yeah.
But was that the last time that you've talked and or saw him?
Yeah. That was it. That night, I mean, you know, like, I feel like everything that I think about and things that I do are usually just written on the wall for me already. And I think that concert, like, when I was doing press beforehand, I was telling people that I was going to do the concert because all of my artists was actually living and they was healthy.
Right. I saw that on the Breakfast Club.
Yeah.
You mentioned you didn't want to wait for an event to happen in order to celebrate everything that's going on because you saw Jay-Z and Fat Joe.
Not Jay-Z, but it was 50 Cent.
50 Cent, yeah.
And, you know, they both was managed by the same person, but while that person was alive, they couldn't settle their beefs. And they didn't even really, like, I don't even think they ever took the time to say, you know what, we're giving this guy who's helped both of us a bigger headache because we can't keep up, you know what I mean, we can't get 100%. Ourselves together.
Yeah.
And it had to be that simple because when he loses his life, then they figured it out, right? And it's like, damn, why you couldn't have figured it out beforehand?
Right.
So that was one of the situations that was motivating me. And it was just like, while I'm looking around, I see people, you know, everybody got their own things that they go through in life, but everybody that was part of my, you know, team was able to be on that stage. And that it was just, you know, that was the time. I think it was heaven sent. God meant for me to do it at that particular point in time.
I believe definitely that the universe creates this energy that you're supposed to be at the right place at the right time.
Yeah.
And that was it. That's one sick way to celebrate and to go out.
Yeah.
All right, so who does Jermaine Dupri idolize?
Real entrepreneurs. I think, like, recently, you know, in the latter years of 2000, we call everybody an entrepreneur.
Right.
But real entrepreneurs are people that, to me, are guys that don't fall for the bullshit, and they really stand for what they really believe in, right? They don't stop until they get to that point of what they believe in. Not they just take whatever to get to the next step. They really are, you know, devoted to what they totally believe.
Yeah.
And those are the guys that
they don't compromise it.
Yeah, they don't compromise. All of the bad times that's in between them getting to that place, they feel like it's just a building block, right? So
right.
It's like I look at those guys every day and I be thinking about it because, like, you know, like right now in the music business for me, it's so much more that I want besides just a record deal or to have a deal with a company, right? I did that so long ago. So it's like in moving forward and thinking about your thoughts, you have to, you know, the business will make you just make a move because you think that people want to, hey, what's going on, right?
Mm-hmm.
But if you really do, you know, dedicated to what you feel should happen, you got to stay focused on that.
I mean, to get to the level of success that you have attained, it could not have been an easy road, right? People look at Jermaine Dupri now and they're thinking to themselves, they probably don't know how much struggle it took in the beginning to get Atlanta on the map to be a full force in hip hop. What was the biggest struggle or biggest obstacle you faced in order to get to that next level?
I'm young. That's probably it. You know, the funny part about it is like when I was starting, young people weren't accepted in the music business the way they are now. Now everybody wants to be young.
Everybody,
you know, everybody's talking about old people, but. Yeah, when I came, everybody was, like, in denial. Like, you're too young to make records. You're too young to go into these meetings. You're too young to know what is supposed to happen with other people. You know, you know, I came in at like 17, 18, so they was looking like, and I was really like voiceful about everything that I wanted to happen,
yeah.
Especially with Crisscross, and they just was like, what does he know? Like, who has he signed before this that we should listen to him?
Right. It's all about validity.
Yeah.
Right?
Well, at that time, it was just like, they didn't understand, like I said, the younger side of it or whatever it is. But, like I said, as time grows on now, it's like everybody's young. Everybody's paying attention. So those are the obstacles. I just had to really, like, continue to keep proving myself. Like,
right.
And, you know, with that was just to stay focused. Make my records. Find a group. Make more records, find a group, make more records, find a group, and just stay focused. And then you start making people respect that, the focusness, you know, the focus.
Exactly right.
I said focusness.
Well, we're gonna put that in Urban Dictionary later on. So who's the most important person in your life?
My kids, probably. You know what I mean? That's at the end of the day, that's what it's all about. It's for them. You know what I mean?
See them that often?
It's going to go to them. Yeah.
I thought you were going to hook me up with the inheritance. I don't know. I just thought that.
It all goes. But yeah, my daughter just turned 15.
Congratulations.
Which is nervous for me.
Does she have a boyfriend?
I took her to get her learner's permit. No boyfriend that I know of.
Yeah.
And she, you know, she knows that I shouldn't know about a boyfriend. So, you know, she knows that her life is going to end if she has a boyfriend.
In the Ferrari or Jaguar, switching four lanes with the top down, screaming out money ain't a thing.
Bubble hard in the double law, flashing the rings with the window crack, holla back, money ain't a thing.
Jigga, I don't like it if it don't gleam. What? In the hell with the price, but the money ain't a thing.
Put it down hard for my dogs that's locked in the bang. When you hit the brakes, new whips, money ain't a thing.
Come on. Yeah, I wanna floss with us.
Come on.
Across the board, we burn it up. Drop a little paper, baby, toss it up. Slacking on your pimpin', turn it up. See the money ain't a thing.
Flex the road, sign a check for your hoe. Jigga style is love, X and O. Save all your accolades, just the dough. My game is wide, all names aside. Trying to stay alive, 100,000 for the bracelet. Foolish ain't out of chain, a strain your eye. Twin platinum gun, son, aim for the sky. Ice on my bullet, you die soon as I pull it. Willies wanna rub shoulders, your money too.